and see you then. I'm Patrick Bonner, the future of nuclear medicine. I'm here today with my fellow radiology classmates to teach you a thing or two about indirect and direct supervision. Direct and indirect supervision creates a safe environment for the technologist, the student, and the patient. In the early years, you were able to radiate anything and anyone your little heart desired.
Fire engine home!
With great advancement in radiation safety, we found a way to make the world and x-rays a safe place to be in. So please, sit back, relax, and enjoy this educational video.
This is the story of about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. So I'd like to take a minute, have a seat on the stool, tell you about the time I got out of x-ray school.
Lawrence, Massachusetts, where I learned x-rays. Class and clinical is where I spend most of my days, chilling out, messing, taking pictures of bones, so one day I'd be a great tech and do it all on my own.
As I'm learning new stuff, there's a tech in the room. That's direct supervision, that's for me and you. Cause when I make a huge mistake and I get real scared, supervising tech will save the day, they'll always be there.
According to Policy 8 in the handbook, as a student, you must always have a certified tech either showing, assisting, or watching you directly in the room. The supervising technologist must review, evaluate, and approve the images taken.
I practice real hard, day after day, take constructive criticism in the best way, until I'm ready to pass the competency exam, prove that I don't need no one to hold my hand.
And when I pass the comp, when I prove that I can, I do a little dance and think, yeah, I'm a man. Then I can do it with indirect supervision, which means I'm smart enough to make responsible decisions.
Also according to Policy 8, once you've completed and passed a competency exam, you are able to perform the exam under indirect supervision. This is when you can perform the exam alone, as long as the technologist is readily available in the department. Don't forget, a qualified technologist must always approve the images before sending.
But let me tell you about the day something didn't go right. I did a chest x-ray and my PA was out of sight, but when the lateral came up, it wasn't that great. The patient was rotated, a repeat was my fate.
For a repeat image, you should always get a tech, but I knew just how to fix it. I knew I was the best. I repositioned the patient, I put it all on the line, and with that third exposure, nothing came out fine!
According to Policy 14, under no circumstances can a student repeat an image without direct supervision. The technologist must check your changes made before re-exposing the patient.
As I was trying to fix my careless mistake, a tech came in the room and did a double take. Did you take a repeat without my consent?
Did you take an x-ray without my consent?
He yelled a little more. It was wicked intense.
My stubborn mistakes got me academic probation, all because I thought I could fix that damn rotation. When I got caught again doing repeats alone.
Jeez.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
Nothing? What's that?
An x-ray.
Taking repeats?
No.
Really?
Yeah.
Four images for a chest x-ray?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. That's protocol here. Sure. That's what we do here. Four images. So, what are you doing?
Call Pat and Angela.
Why?
You're out of the program.
No!
I got kicked out of the program. No, my x-rays are bone.
Take a look at my future. There was nothing much there except to sit on my throne made of regret and despair.
I hope you enjoyed this feature presentation. And I hope you're able to take away something that you learned in this video that can help you your education as a student in radiography. And students, remember, If you don't adhere to these policies, you're beat, kid.
I can't.
Stop. This shit that ice cold, Michelle fight for that white gold. This one for them hood girls, them good girls, straight masterpieces. Stylin', wildin', living it up in the city.
Yo, hold on, no, let me know when I'm starting.
Running.
Hold on, I know what I'm doing. No, I got you,
right.
I got you.
It's recording, so just whenever
you're ready. Well, hello, I'm Patrick Bonner, future of nuclear medicine. Is that all right?
I'm too hot. Call the police and the fireman, I'm too hot. Make a dragon wanna retire, man, I'm too hot. Say my name, you know who I am, I'm too hot. And my band bought that money, break it down. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk gon' give it to you.
Cause Uptown Funk gon' give it to you.
Cause Uptown Funk gon' give it to you. Saturday night and we in the spot. Don't believe me, just watch.
The head turn, you can't do the
That's
head turn.
Go back. Oh!
I gotcha.
Bobby's got me.
Angela, about that test that I had.
Don't believe me, just watch. 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 Hey, hey, hey.
Oh, that's awesome.
Okay,
wow.
Ready?
Don't believe me, just watch. 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 Hey, 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 oh.
Was that right?
Yeah, that was perfect.
I'm looking all around.
We're not done yet. Sit down.
Oh my god. You gotta be kidding me. I don't even know what I just said.